This is News 3 Now at 5:30.
It was less than 4 months ago on December 14th when the first coronavirus vaccine shots in Wisconsin went into the arms right here in Madison at UW Hospital. Now, 105 days later, the state is reporting 1 million Wisconsinites are fully vaccinated against the virus. DHS data shows just over 17% of the state's population has finished its vaccination series. That includes more than 56% of people at least 65 years old. Those numbers are a bit higher here in Dane County. About 1 in 5 people are fully vaccinated against the virus, while nearly 90% of people ages 65 and up have received all of their shots. Only 7,200 shots went into arms around the state yesterday. That is a significant drop from the days before. It's because fewer vaccination clinics are open on Sundays. DHS is reporting 296 new cases of the virus. 3 more people have died. President Biden says there's a good chance everyone in the country will be able to sign up for a vaccine by the middle of next month.
I'm directing my COVID team to ensure there is a vaccine site within 5 miles of 90% of all Americans by April the 19th, 3 weeks from today.
In a speech from the White House, President Biden pleaded with governors and all Americans to not let up on COVID precautions. He called it a life and death race against the virus. Do you want to get a COVID vaccine this week, even if you're not technically eligible? Well, you might be able to get one, but you need to be willing to drive. Amanda Quintana explains why the Ho-Chunk Nation had extra doses for the general public this month and where you have to go. Amanda?
Yes, well, although many people didn't hear about this opportunity until just recently, Ho-Chunk Nation has been offering up some of their vaccines to the general public, anyone who is over the age of 18 all month long. Now, they say that they went through their tiers really quickly and they had a bunch of vaccine left over.
I don't know if we overestimated the interest in the vaccine. However, we have the capacity to vaccinate at least 1,000 people a day, and we still have yet to hit that mark.
DHS has been prioritizing vaccine for American Indian populations, such as the Ho-Chunk Nation, but the Tribal Health Department is struggling to find people to vaccinate.
We've got the vaccine, it's getting the people there to get the vaccine.
Kiana Bodine, executive director at the Ho-Chunk Nation Department of Health, says many are hesitant to get the shot, waiting to see what the long-term effects might be.
I think mainly it's going to be seeing more people of their ethnicity or whatever group that they're from getting the vaccine and sharing their experiences with them. We can talk about the science until we're blue in the face, but really I think they trust the people that they know the best.
With a visit from Governor Evers last week and media campaigns trying to convince tribal members to trust the shot,
I'm doing it for like my grandparents.
Ho-Chunk Nation has been able to vaccinate a little over 40% of tribal members, lower than Bodine would like to see.
The younger population, we're really having the most trouble getting them in.
Their dashboard shows most shots going to non-tribal members. Once clinics were opened up to the general public, slots filled up fast. Registration for one in Baraboo on Wednesday already closed, with just one more on Thursday before going back to focusing on their own population with less vaccine.
We're pretty burnt out and we're going to downsize and just continue to focus on tribal members of any tribe, their descendants, and Ho-Chunk Nation employees.
The Ho-Chunk Nation is really focusing on trying to get to those younger people, those tribal members that are 18 to 24, because only 8% of them have been vaccinated. Bodine says that a lot of them think that they won't actually get that sick if they get COVID, but the issue is that they could spread it to older people as well. And as for that clinic in Black River Falls on Thursday, there should be a few slots left open. We have information on how to sign up on channel3000.com.
Some doctors are expressing concern it might take longer to get to herd immunity here in Wisconsin since no vaccines are currently approved for children. UW Health's Dr. Nazia Softar says herd immunity would mean 70 to 80% of the general population gets a shot. But she says it's hard to give a timeline on a return to normal if kids cannot get the shot yet.
I think everything really hinges on the supply. I think by summer is not unreasonable for certain segments of the population. But you know, there's only the one vaccine that's approved for children ages 16 to 18. And so there is that constraint. And then, of course, we don't have any for people that are younger than that.
Dr. Safdar says if more people choose not to get the vaccine when it's their turn in line, the more difficult it will be to reach herd immunity in 2021. New concerns over the spread of the virus in Rock County. Health officials there say they have found COVID-19's UK variant. The strain was first found in England in November. It's believed to spread more easily and quickly than the virus's original strain. Officials say it's important for people to keep wearing masks and distancing to slow that spread. Let's check your first warm forecast now with Chief Meteorologist Gary Kenalty.
Charlotte, the winds are howling out here. We're seeing some wind gusts in the 40 to 50 mile per hour range over much of southern Wisconsin. Those are mild winds. Visible cloud track shows a bank of clouds coming through early this morning. That's actually with the warm front. And on Doppler track, other than a few flurries of snow east of Lake Superior into Canada, very dry across the upper Midwest. Temperatures started out in the middle 20s to around 30 this morning. Look where temperatures have gone since then. High temperatures so far, middle 60s to lower 70s, and current temperatures are right about at those high temperatures for the day. A little cooler closer to Lake Michigan, though. Milwaukee at 59 and temperatures in the 40s up over east central Wisconsin. But those winds out of the south gusting 40 to almost 50 miles per hour here in Madison. Wind gusts this hour to 44 miles per hour. Wind advisories remain in effect until 8 p.m. tonight. The winds will remain strong overnight, but should die down at least a little bit after sunset. By tomorrow morning, it will be down to around 48 degrees. The skies turn partly cloudy. Tomorrow will be a cloudy, breezy, and cool day with a high of 52 and temperatures holding nearly steady for much of the day, even a slight chance for a shower. Colder weather, though, arrives for Wednesday and Thursday. I'll tell you what our temperatures will be in just a few minutes.
Still ahead at 5:30, the latest from the first day of the George Floyd murder trial. Plus, with jury trials set to restart here in Dane County in June, how the criminal justice system is planning to manage a massive backlog of cases. And there's more local news ahead, why some people feel initial appearances during the pandemic are violating constitutional rights. That story tonight after the Elite Eight, right here on CBS.
Does it really matter how beef is trimmed? Meet the facts. Fact: Hy-Vee has higher standards when it comes to trimming beef. Hy-Vee Choice Reserve is trimmed with only 1/4 inch of fat. So you pay for the meat, not for the fat. And get what you pay for. Are you getting what you pay for? Stop paying for the fat. Check out meetthefacts.hy-vee.com.
At the Dells, an attraction not to be missed. With over 60 of the world's biggest brands, we thrill family vacationers, trendsetters, and all who love a smoking hot discount. We're all about the thrill of the deal, the joy of finding the thing you forgot to pack, the swimsuit that's the hit of the park, the dress that makes you walk with swagger, and the discounts that no one else can touch. Save even more with 25% off and get free jump time at Knuckleheads. Visit outletsatthedells.com for coupon and details.
It's the Mattress Madness sale at Steinhoffel's. Get great deals on all the best mattress brands, like a Queen Beautyrest silver mattress for the price of a twin, a free box spring with any Dreams Cool Copper or Cool Touch mattress, or buy a purple hybrid and get a free pillow and sheet set. Make your new mattress more affordable with Steinhoffel's special 60-month financing and free delivery. Only at Steinhoffel's and Steinhoffel's.com.
Wisconsin is a home of workers. We know what needs to get done, and we do it. Yet, we've been hit hard, some harder than others. Our contact may be limited, but we still can lift each other up. Your local Wisconsin energy and emergency rental assistance providers are working together to keep you safely in your home. You may not ask for it, but we want you to know we're here to help.
You're watching News 3 Now at 5:30.
We very rarely get incidents where police are actively on a scene. And they had changed. They had come from the back of the squad to the ground, and my instincts were telling me that something's wrong. Something has not right. I don't know what, but something wasn't right.
ground.
The first witnesses have testified in Derek Chauvin's trial. The former Minneapolis officer is charged with the death of George Floyd last year on Memorial Day. 911 dispatcher Jenna Scurry was the first witness called on by the prosecution. In their opening statements, the prosecution said Scurry could see Floyd's arrest on a live feed camera. Scurry says what she saw on the camera was so disturbing that she called the police on the police. The defense says officers, including Chauvin, struggled to arrest Floyd. The trial is expected to last about 4 weeks. Here in Dane County, thousands of criminal cases wait on resolution as courts slowly prepare to open back up to jury trials in June. In part two of a series focused on the pandemic's impacts on criminal justice, investigative reporter Naomi Coles explains how the system plans to manage the massive backlog.
Never before have we really had to think about a disease that can literally cause death if we gather in places like courtrooms.
When jury trials closed a year ago, the scramble to adjust criminal justice to the pandemic slowed down case resolutions and created a backlog that's still growing.
They're having that weight that are that's basically hanging over their head, trying to figure out, like, hey, what's going on? What's going to be, what's my next step?
We are all going to have some serious challenges managing the backlog.
Criminal defense attorneys say dealing with that backlog could take months, if not a year or more.
And we're going to have jury trial after jury trial after jury trial. So it's going to be pure pandemonium when this opens back up.
In February, there are more than 8,000 open criminal cases in Dane County, although most of those won't end in a trial. The long delay in bringing trials back has to balance competing responsibilities, rights to a speedy trial, and the burden of public safety.
If you have jury members that are more concerned about their personal health and getting out of this building, that's hard to expect them to do that and concentrate on the weighty tasks that they have.
A plan finalized in Dane County to return to jury trials on June 1st will include prioritization of the most serious cases.
Once we start, then all the speedy trial clocks will start with that.
And those that have been around the longest or have victims who need resolution.
The way we move forward, I think, is the way that we've kind of struggled through the last year, which is with a lot of patience and creativity.
Moving forward is going to be hard because there are an enormous amount of cases stacked up on our attorneys and the court system that we're going to have to work through to get back to where we were pre-pandemic.
But with reopening will come many lessons learned.
I think if we can put our heads together and work together and actually sit in the same room together rather than try to negotiate or talk over Zoom or email, we can get a lot done.
Some of those lessons include potentially keeping Zoom for initial or short court appearances. Dane County District Attorney Ishmael Ozan says that would help result in fewer missed court dates, which contribute to jail population.
Because some of the things that we've been able to do have kept our jail population down. Some of those are artificial, but I still think we can learn from this experience moving forward.
And when sorting through the backlog, recommendations from a National Criminal Justice COVID Task Force hone in on a few key solutions. Those include more settlement conferences, sharing caseloads with other counties, and identifying cases that can be resolved quickly.
Get those cases done. You can get those done in 10 days after arrest in most cases. So pay attention more to those early case resolution opportunities.
For News 3 Investigates, I'm Naomi Coles.
Check our website, channel3000.com, for the first part in this series, exploring how that backlog happened and how case resolutions have dropped during the pandemic. Still ahead at 5:30, kids are back at Madison's Children's Zoo for the first time in more than a year. And a tortilla company in the 608 gets recognized for its efforts in the community. Plus, the wind sticks around before a warm-up for Easter Sunday. Gary has your first warm forecast next.
When it comes to weather, only one thing really matters: accuracy.
Only one station can be the best.
News 3 Now. First Warn Weather has the most accurate forecast, according to WeatherRate.
Count on First Warn Weather for your most accurate forecast.
One night, three ladies and dozens of hits. It's the Ladies of the 80s Tour, featuring Taylor Dayne, Lisa Lisa, and Evelyn Champagne King. together live June 5th at Ho-Chunk Gaming Wisconsin Dells. Tickets are on sale now through Ticketmaster and at the Ho-Chunk Gaming gift shop. The Red Hot Dance Party you've been waiting for. Taylor Dane, Lisa Lisa, and Evelyn Champagne King. June 5th at Ho-Chunk Gaming Wisconsin Dells. Your grown-up getaway.
Love lower than low prices? Then get more ways to save at Pick and Save, where you can find personalized coupons, weekly deals, and rewards like fuel points. All for prices that are lower than low. On food that's fresher than fresh. Pick and Save. Fresh for everyone.
There's been much debate about the Mona Lisa smile. Would it have been bigger and brighter if she'd had good dental care? Maybe if Physicians Mutual Insurance Company had been around back then, it'd be a different story. She could have gone to the dentist more, knowing she'd have help paying the bills. And those regular checkups might have found early signs of tooth decay or gum disease, costly problems that could keep anyone from smiling. Physicians Mutual offers affordable coverage that can help pay for cleanings and unexpected or expensive procedures you might need, like crowns or dentures. This is real dental insurance, not just a discount plan or for checkups only. There are no deductibles, and there's no annual maximum. Plus, you can see any dentist you want. Call or go online today for a free information kit from Physicians Mutual. Get the dental care you need to help you stay healthy. For your free information kit with all the details, call us now or go to sendinfokit.com.
For over 25 years, Fry Construction has provided excellence in home improvements. We strive to exceed the expectations of our clients with each and every project we do. Respected by so many of your neighbors and voted best of Madison, Fry Construction delivers lasting quality for your home. In honor of our 25 years, we're offering 25% off gutters or insulation with any full roof project. Schedule your consultation today at fryconstruction.com.
You're watching News 3 Now at 5:30.
A local company that started in Lone Rock is getting some big recognition. Tortilleria Zepeda recently made an appearance on Wisconsin's version of Shark Tank. It's called Project Pitch It. Tortilleria Zepeda makes tortillas with locally sourced corn using traditional Mexican techniques. You can find their products across the Madison area. The show's judges were impressed with their emphasis on local.
It's really good to know who is growing your food, which ingredients you have in your food. So we really are making a clean product with no preservative, and I think that's also like really, really important.
The show awarded them $5,000 as well as business assistance from an entrepreneurship center. You can find their tortillas at area grocery stores and in restaurants in our area like Bear and Bottle and Canteen. If you'd like to learn more, go to this story under the In the 608 tab on our website. Well, kids are back in the Henry Vilas Children's Zoo. It reopened today for the first time in more than a year. Officials say the Children's Zoo is one of the last areas of the zoo to reopen to the public. The zoo's carousel is also now available for rides every day. All visitors at least 5 years old are required to wear a face covering. And Gary, a windy day at the zoo, but at least we have the beautiful sunshine.
Well, with the wind and the sunshine, those temperatures really took off today compared to where they were yesterday at this time. Three things you need to know in our forecast, though. It'll be breezy and not as mild for tomorrow as temperatures drop back into the lower 50s. We'll see those temperatures hold nearly steady through the day, and there's even a slight chance for a shower. Then chilly weather returns for Wednesday and Thursday. Highs only in the upper 30s on Wednesday and in the lower 40s on Thursday before we see another surge of mild air at the end of the week and just in time for the Easter weekend. Breezy, highs in the middle 50s on Friday and mid 60s expected for Saturday and for Easter Sunday. So you can kind of tell the wind direction. The winds are out of the south. The temperatures warm up when they're out of the north or northwest. Those temperatures drop down like they will over the next couple of days, but notice the warm up for the weekend. Next week, temperatures not as confident on these. It will depend on the position of a front. If it stays to the south of us, we'll be on the cool side of the front and temperatures will mainly be in the 50s with some rain chances. Should that front move farther to the north, the rain chances will go down and the temperatures will go up. up. Maximum wind gusts today, 45 to 50 miles per hour or more across much of the central part of the Midwest here in Madison. Wind gusts to 45 miles per hour. Dubuque, Iowa, wind gusts to 52 miles per hour so far. And just within the last hour, we're still seeing winds almost in the mid 40 mile per hour range here in Madison and near 50 miles per hour in Dubuque. We have wind advisories that remain in effect until 8 p.m. tonight for all of southern and southwestern Wisconsin, as well as much of Iowa and Minnesota. Farther to the northwest, high wind warnings in effect for parts of the Dakotas. And relative humidities are low. That air moving out of the south, very dry. So relative humidities are between about 25 and 35%. That's leading to high fire danger with red flag warnings in effect for northwestern Illinois, Iowa, and much of the central part of the country from Texas all the way up to the U.S.-Canadian border. This area starting to get into drought conditions, even though Tennessee got slammed with 8 to 9 inches of rain over the weekend. So it's either a have or a have-not situation for parts of the country. But temperatures right now are in the have side for the warm weather. Temperatures 70s and 80s to our south and west. Look at the drop in temperatures to the north and west. Compared to 24 hours ago, temperatures are up about 30 degrees over Minnesota and down by about 50 degrees over parts of northern Montana. That is a big switch in temperatures. And usually when you see those big switches in temperatures, the pressure changes and so the winds start to howl. Wind advisories in effect until 8 p.m. tonight for almost all of southern Wisconsin. For tomorrow, look for a high of 52. So not as mild as today. It'll be breezy. Those winds, though, out of the west, and there is a slight chance for a shower. Even colder weather for Wednesday with a high of 38 and breezy. 41 on Thursday after an early morning low of 18. But then those temperatures go back up into the mid-50s on Friday. Mid-60s for the Easter weekend. Shower and thunderstorm chances arrive early next week and then toward Wednesday and Thursday. High temperatures upper 50s to the middle 60s.
Marquette is hoping Shaka Smart is the key to the Golden Eagles heading back to the NCAA tournament. Highlights from the Oregon Native's introductory press conference after the break.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Wild East Town Honda is Wisconsin's Dealer of the Year. Save with 0% financing for up to 60 months on over 400 new Hondas. At Wild East Town Honda in Madison. It's gotta be wild.
Menards carries the everyday supplies you need. Save on a great selection of Rayovac products. Stock up on batteries for devices you use every day. A 48-pack of double or AAA batteries is $10.97 after 11% rebate. Then head to the housewares department for your laundry supplies. We have the brands you can trust. This 42-pack of Clean Breeze Tide Pods is $9.99 after 11% rebate now at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
It's a fact. We use our internet and TV more than ever, with most of us spending nearly 7 hours a day online. So it's no wonder thousands of families are switching to Spectrum, because most families have up to 8 connected devices, which means they need even more speed. Switch to Spectrum Internet and get the fastest starting speeds for the price, 200 megabits for just $44.99 a month, with a free modem and free security suite included. Call 833-546-4499. When it comes to TV, we're watching more than ever. In fact, 80% of us watch TV every day. Spectrum TV lets you catch all your favorite sports, news, and more live. Plus, download the free Spectrum TV app and watch on your devices. Switch to Spectrum TV from $44.99 a month. Call 833-546-4499. The fact is, Spectrum has the best services at the best price. Switch to Spectrum Internet and TV from $44.99 a month each with no contracts. We'll even buy out your current contract. Call 833-546-4499.
Do you suffer from ED? Did you know there could be a way to relieve ED without harmful medications, needles, or surgery? Peak Performance for Men is here to help. Click or call now to treat your ED. And remember, our results make the difference.
At Wild East Town Honda, lease a new all-wheel drive HRV for $189. That's $189 and absolutely zero due at signing. Save on over 400 new Hondas at Wild East Town Honda in Madison. It's gotta be wild.
Hi, folks. Tuesday morning, we are honoring those on the front lines for National Doctors Day. Meet a local doctor being recognized for his latest efforts on News 3 Now this morning. We'll see you then.
Dane County's beloved Panther is now a Golden Eagle. Shaka Smart wore Marquette colors with pride today at his introductory press conference in Milwaukee. But as Christina Lori shows us, his connections to Oregon just might make people who bleed red and white cheer for the blue and gold.
And it starts with family. My mom, Monica, lives about an hour away from here.
Shaka Smart has always stood out on the court, first as Oregon High School's starting point guard, and later as Virginia Commonwealth's head coach, leading the underdog Rams to a surprise Final Four appearance back in 2011.
He is a man of tremendous character and is someone who cares deeply about personal relationships.
Smart has spent the last six seasons with the Texas Longhorns, where his teams had a winning record but struggled in the Big 12, failing to win a single game in the NCAA tournament.
Welcome to Marquette, and step on up and say a few words.
Today, Smith officially traded in his burnt orange for blue and gold as Marquette's president and athletic director praised him for his talent, values, and conduct on and off the court.
He is an excellent fit for our basketball program and even a better fit for our university.
The humble, hardworking point guard is now the school's 18th head men's basketball coach.
I was born in 1977.
Fittingly, the same year Marquette and Al McGuire won the school's only national title, Smart also took time to salute another historical figure, his high school basketball coach, Kevin Bavery, who's now at Middleton.
He taught me about coaching even while I was still playing. He was one of many, many coaches who spent the time to build a great relationship with me.
So now it's Smart's turn to build new relationships with his new team in his home state. And the expectations are already high.
He's hardworking, he's innovative, and he's already been to the Final Four.
Smart replaces Steve Wojciechowski, who went 128-95 over his seven seasons with the Golden Eagles. Reporting in Madison for News 3 Now, I'm Christina Lori.
Welcome to my alma mater. Smart will have some work to do. This year, the Golden Eagles had their first losing season since 2014. The NCAA tournament continues tonight right here on WISC. Two teams will punch their tickets to the Final Four. It starts with Oregon State and Houston after the news. Arkansas and Baylor will tip off at about 9 o'clock. And News 3 Now at 10 will air right after that second game. And here's Gary with the final check.
Well, we have wind advisories that remain in effect until 8 p.m. tonight for all of southern Wisconsin. We're still seeing some wind gusts to 45 to almost 50 miles per hour. Keep that in mind if you're out driving tonight.
Thank you, Gary, and thank you for joining us. Stay tuned for the